Yeah, so that's my mind. चंद्रा इति संकल्पः कामयेव च
संकल्पः कामयेव च निराभ्यासो आत्मबाया
विवेकृत्यो आत्ममायम्
हृदयं निरभिद्यता
हृदयं निरभिद्यता
ततो मनश्चन्द्र इति
ततो मनश्चन्द्र इति
संकल्पः कामयेव च
संकल्पः कामयेव च
ज्ञानं तत्र गरं दस्य ज्ञानं जनासा the soul gets a new seat. The heart is just the seat of the soul. But the person is the same. The person is the soul. So the soul is the same, sitting there in the heart, along with the super soul. And the mind, the own determination and all desire became manifest. Determination, very important quality. Rupa Goswami mentions about determination in the Upadeshamrita. Utsaham nishchaya dharya tat tat karma pravaha sangat satat sato vritte chatir bhakti. Rupa Goswami mentions the items which are favorable for devotional service. So he said enthusiasm, patience, and determination. So as devotees, of course, we have to have determination. To control the mind and to control the senses requires determination. Sense control requires determination. Why people cannot control their senses? They're not determined. They're not really convinced that this is a very important. They don't take it very seriously. No determination. Determination, Prabhupada said these days, enthusiasm, patience, determination are there necessary in all endeavors, and especially in Krishna consciousness also. But anybody doing business, you need to have these qualities. Anybody getting married, life, and having a family, you need to have these qualities. And everything, you know, whatever you do, you study, you're working, you're teaching, you have to have enthusiasm, you have to be patient, you have to be determined. So determination, this is coming from the mind. That conviction that I can do it. I'm going to do it. You know, that's how to be convinced. But we may succeed or we may fail. That will be decided by Krishna. But that determination to try, that is required. We have to have that determination that I have to try and do this. I have to try to become Krishna conscious. I have to try to go back to Godhead. And we don't know if we can succeed or not, but we have to try. We have to have some determination. Determination to Prabhupada defines determination endeavoring for Krishna consciousness. That endeavor, in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna said, Vaya vasai atmika bhuti ekeha purananda. Those who are on this path are resolute in determination. Resolute in determination. You see that fixed determination. They're very determined, they want to do this, so they're resolute in determination. They're not going to give up easily, they're not going to give up. They may fail, they may not be successful, but they're going to endeavor, they're going to try. So they have that resolute determination. This is Vaya Vasayat Vikabhuti. But those who are irresolute, Bahushaka Yananda, those who are irresolute, their determination is many branched. But we have to understand the nature of desire. Cannot stop desire, but we can purify desire. The Mayavadis, impersonalists, they want to be desireless. The Buddhists, they think you can become without desire. Stop all desire. It's not that we have to just desire for our own comfortable living or desire for our own sense gratification. No, we have to desire in relation to Krishna. So that is proper use of desire. And these desires are coming from the mind. The mind can be the enemy, but the mind can be the friend. It's up to us how we use the mind. Are we going to be the servant of our own desires? We have to know what is proper to desire, what is actually good for our progress in Krishna consciousness. So we need to have that kind of determination. In the Bhagavad Gita, Prabhupada gives an example about determination. The little sparrow trying to drink the ocean. The little sparrow lost its eggs to the ocean. And the little sparrow was so upset that the ocean had taken its eggs. It vowed, "I will drink the ocean dry." So how can a little sparrow ever drink the ocean dry? But the little sparrow was very determined. And news came to Garuda, the king of the birds. They heard that this little bird is vowed going to drink the ocean dry because it lost its eggs. So Garuda is a Vaishnava. He was compassionate. And when he heard about the little bird, he came there. And he told the god of the ocean, he told Varuna, "You give it this little bird his eggs back, or I will drink you dry." So Garuda is very powerful. So the god of the ocean brought the eggs, gave them back to the sparrow. So that's the kind of determination we need. In Chinese culture, they always speak a lot about determination. They have another saying, an idiom, Chinese idiom, they have a lot of idiom. The old man wants to move the mountain. The old man had land, but there was a big mountain on the land. So he thought, I will make it flat. How will we make it? I'll knock down the mountain. I'll take away the mountain. Other people that were laughing at him, they thought the old fool, he wants to move the mountain. But the old fool, he thought, I may not be able to move the mountain, but some of it I'll move and the rest will be done in the future. My sons and my son's son, one day will move the mountain. So like that, determination. You have to have that kind of faith and determination. If we have strong faith, then we'll have that determination. So we have to be careful to always control the mind and control the quality of our desire. Desires are going to be there, and you cannot stop desire for very long. Prabhupada gives an example about the glass. If the glass is full, then nothing can come in. But if the glass is empty, not full, then things will come in the glass. You'll get impurities, different things are going to enter. So the mind is like that, like the glass. We have to keep our mind always engaged in the service of Krishna. Right? Maharaj Ambarish fixed his mind. Very beginning, the first thing he did was to fix his mind on the lotus feet of the Lord. And Lochandas Thakur, he says, Bhaja Hari Manya Sri Nanda Nandana Apaya Charanara Bindari. Engage the mind in the service of the lotus feet of Sanatana Maharaj. And in this way, you will become fearless. If we take shelter of Lord Krishna, very important to control the mind. And that training of the mind comes by chanting Hare Krishna mantra. I told you before, one devotee said, we're training our gladiators to conquer the mind in the arena of japa. When we do our japa every day, that's where we have to train the mind. We have to focus the mind on the holy name. Wherever the mind wanders, we have to bring it back. We cannot allow the mind just to go here and there. We have to bring it back. Use the mind to hear the holy name. And if we hear the holy name, then we won't be thinking any other thing. There will be no other desires. If the mind is always full with thought of Krishna, then nothing else can enter. So we have to practice always thinking of Krishna. And we can do it by reading Srimad Bhagavatam and by reciting slokas. And this one lady, Prabhupada said, Narayani, she's a very senior devotee and she travels around preaching. She's an American. Been a devotee since 1970, and she teaches classes. She teaches like Bhakti Vaibhava, Bhakti, all this Bhakti Vedanta. So she told how she memorized the verses. She had, every day she would recite all the verses for memorization, and she recited them every day for more than a year. And this way she learned all the verses. So you recite them every day, you recite the verses, you learn them. You have to, of course, you have to also use them. When you memorize the verse, you want to be able to use it. So it's important, anyway, to learn these verses, just like Mukunda Prabhu in Bhakti Vaibhava, Damayanti also in Bhakti Vaibhava. So you have to memorize so many slokas, right? Bhagavatam slokas. And Bhagavad Gita slokas, they're easy. But Bhagavatam slokas are a bit more difficult, right? Especially the first three or the very first verse can be difficult. If you haven't learned it before, then it can be difficult. There's so much to learn, so much to memorize. But if you say them every day, it becomes natural, you know, they're there on your tongue. They get fit, they enter, put them in your mind, right? You have to train the mind to remember Krishna. How to remember Krishna? By hearing, by chanting, and by preaching about Krishna, telling people about Krishna. Just like we learn slokas, we have to use them. We want to use them. When we give a class and like that, we're trying to quote some slokas, like Krishna is called Uttama Shloka, right? So, like this is training our mind to always be fixed.
How the affection by the priest karma for the determination?
Is it affecting by our karma?
Purva karma or karma. Sometimes people are very enthusiasm and after some time they will.
Yes, well, definitely our karma could have some influence there. People generally, the by too much sense gratification. The more we have sense gratification, the weaker our determination will be. So sense gratification, we have to be very regulated in our activities. But if we're inclined, uncontrolled in our senses, then our determination will be weak. So what determines why is a person more inclined to sense gratification? Some people, they can be very, very much attached to just enjoying the senses. How to enjoy the senses? Comfortable living, I can't live like that, I have to have this, I can't go on a motorbike, I have to have a car, I can't drive a good one, I have to have a BMW or something. People have their ideas about their standards. I can't eat that, I'd better eat better food than this. This is just junk food, I can't eat this. Some people have some standards about, I can't live in that place, that place. No way, I couldn't live there. People have their attachments about what they want, how they want to live, what they want to do. So determination has to be there. One can adjust, one can accept difficulty. You could say that determination is like tapasya, like austerity, is accept voluntarily undergoing some difficulties. That kind of determination required. People have weak determination because they never control their senses. They're accustomed to eat every day. They have no regulated principles. So they'll have weak determination. But Krishna consciousness helps people to develop determination. The more they're engaged in Krishna consciousness, then they get spiritual strength. And with spiritual strength, there will be determination. So some people, you could say it's a karma. But devotional service doesn't depend on karma. Some people may have very bad karma, but they can be very good. Very miserable, even though they have very bad karma. You can say, the person is very diseased, and very poor, education, very bad karma. But it can be a very good devotee. And if someone's a good devotee, they'll have all the good qualities come to one with a devotee. If we are connected to Krishna, we're trying to serve Krishna, then Krishna will give us whatever is necessary. So determination is not just karma. If we want to get determination, Krishna can give us that strength.
Without determination, we can depend with the mercy of the future master. Yeah. When there were no determination, but they say we are depend with the mercy. Can that progress?
Well, that just as you say like that, you mentioned spiritual master. A devotee will naturally say that.
sadhaka must think this is a mercy of Krishna. Whatever the determination is coming from the mercy of Guru.
Detachment is coming by the mercy of the Guru.
Determination.
Determination. Well, all the problem is has come as all everything, whatever to have to be prepared to the Guru. That is the antidote. By the mercy of the spiritual master we get the mercy of Krishna. So if we're, you know, if we've got any good credit, any good assets, we give the credit to Guru. It's all my Guru's mercy. I am nothing. I have no good qualities. But somehow, by the mercy of my Guru, I'm able to do something.
It's a proper etiquette of the devotees. That is a proper etiquette of the devotees.
Yes. Yeah. Prabhupada does like that. You know, when he's writing also, he's always writing, Guru finds his Guru. And when he publishes the book, he said, my Guru will be very pleased that he printed this book. Gives him credit. And he prays for them when he's writing. He prays before Krishna Das Kaviraj wrote Chaitanya Charitamrita. He went to the deities and prayed to the deities. And he went to the Vaishnavas and took the blessing. Try something, we want to get the blessing, and afterwards, if we say whatever, we give the credit to the Guru.
Maharaj, while chanting, if our mind is keep on thinking more on other matter, how do we get back to the chanting? How do we divert our mind to hear the chanting of our mantra?
Well, wherever the mind wanders, bring it back. Bring it back. Focus it on the holy name. Then the mind will wander. That's its nature. In conditioned state, our mind wanders, but we have to bring it back. Wherever the mind goes, you bring it back. Focus on the holy name. Hear the holy name. Don't let the mind just go here and there. So attentive chanting means we focus our mind on the holy name. Sometimes people would ask, what do we think of when we chant? I said, to chant. You hear. Use the tongue to chant and the ear to hear. It's not a question of the mind. If you use the tongue properly and the ear properly, the mind will be submissive. Make the mind submissive. Concentrate on chanting and hearing. So loud chanting helps. More chanting helps. The mind. Arjuna asked, what is one compelled to sinful activities, in unwilling, as if engaged by force? And what did Lord Krishna say? Said it is lust only, O Arjuna, right? Or no contact of the material senses.
First, they say the mind is a representative of moon god. Moon god is in charge of the mind.
The deity of the mind is the moon.
That's moon. Moon is always not steady, always in change. It's nature.
Well, the moon is. No, sometimes we see one portion of the moon, and then sometimes you get the dark moon, and you get the bright moon, you know. It varies. Every day.
I mean, the mind is always
Vaya Vasaya Pika Bhuti. And Lord Krishna was speaking about the mind. Man Mana Bhava Bhava. Engage your mind in thinking of me. Lord Krishna is saying, that's the most confidential knowledge. But when we contemplate the material objects, then we forget Krishna. While contemplating the objects of the senses, one becomes attached to them. And by such attachment, lust develops. And from lust comes anger. From anger, delusion. When one is intelligence is lost and a person falls down again into the pool of materialistic life. So we have to be very careful. On guard constantly. Right? Krishna consciousness is the razor's edge, walking along the edge that is sharp. You don't want to go over. So this way we have to control the mind.
Yeah.